Hey there, Moz and Boo fans, I'm Moz, and this is the second video from our Tamper Evan Challenge series. We are looking at B-sealed EnaTail 2 fixed length seal. This seal has a major design flaw. We will show you what it is and how you can take advantage of it to bypass the seal. The EnaTail 2 is what's called a fixed length seal. On one end, it has a plug, and the other end, it has a locking mechanism. Once connected, it's always the same length. This is different to seals like the pull tight seal. It's like a zip tie and can be pulled tight to different lengths. You'll notice near the plug end, there's a small piece cut out of the band. This isn't actually part of the Tamper Evan design. Well, their website says it isn't. This is so the seal can be easily broken off when you are done with it. You won't need any tools to break it. Some of the other seals, like the cable seal I showed you, will need a tool or cutters to remove. Because of this cutout, it actually makes it hard to bypass the seal, as you can't pull on it. Pulling on it will snap it really quickly. The locking mechanism has four small teeth inside. The plug goes in sliding past these teeth, and then they latch on so you can't pull it back out. Attacking these teeth was the first way we tried bypassing the seal. We cut four small shims, then slid them into the locking mechanism and slowly pulled the plug out. It worked, but it left marks on the plastic because of the shims, and also we had to pull on the seal. Not the best way, and won't pass if someone inspects it closely for tampering. If you look at the end of the seal, you will see a small hole on the other side of the locking mechanism. The B-Sealed website says the hole is there to make it easy to see if the plug had been pushed in fully. This is the design flaw we mentioned at the beginning of this video and makes it very easy to bypass this seal. I already mentioned you can't pull the seal or it snaps, so you just push it instead. This hole lets you push the plug out without leaving a mark. All you need to do is loosen the locking mechanism. And what's the best way to do this? Heat. Heat softens and expands plastic. What will you use to heat it? Well, luckily, I happen to have this heat gun in my pants. I just want to say, I sort of feel bad because it's like we are picking on B-Seal, but we aren't. They say this seal is a low cost fixed loop seal, so it's not expected to be high security. Still, we are surprised they still sell this with the hole. We are guessing they either don't know about this technique, or the hole may have something to do with how they make it, and it's more expensive to make one without the hole. They have holeless versions with their twin lock, ultra lock, and hybrid lock. So I advise buying them if you need fixed length seals. They're way harder to bypass. To perform this bypass, all you need is heat. We will show you how using a heat gun. Something small that can fit through the hole. We will be using the end of a file. This is the same file we used on SetCon when we first worked this out. A small vise can also be handy. You don't need the vise, but it makes it easier if the plus gets too hot. You can use pliers as well. This bypass is pretty easy to do, but like most Tamper Evan bypasses, you need to take your time. The only real thing that can go wrong is if you use too much heat and melt the plastic. When using the heat gun, you hold the seal and start heating up by the locking end. You will try to soften and expand the teeth. There are four of them, so you want to move the heat all the way around. While the plastic is still hot, put your tool into the hole and push through. If the plastic is heated enough, it should just pop out. If it doesn't, keep heating. Once it pops out, you're done. You can now get it into whatever the seal was protecting, then put the seal back on as if no one has ever been there. If you want to learn more ways to bypass Tamper Evan seals and other physical controls, make sure you just subscribe to our YouTube channel and also click the bell icon so you don't miss any of our videos. Also, give us a thumbs up if you liked it. We would love to hear from you in the comments, so if you have any comments or have any ideas for any videos you think we should do, let us know. We will be back soon with another Tamper Evan bypass.